Bryan Johnson's father, Richard, lowered his biological age by 25 years by doing a one-time controversial blood treatment. In this video, we'll go over what it was, the eye-opening science showing the benefits of this treatment, and three ways that you can reproduce this therapy to lower your own biological age. Richard is the father of Bryan Johnson, the famous entrepreneur and longevity interventions guinea pig, spending millions of dollars in hopes of becoming the healthiest and longest lived human. In his late 60s, Richard started to show advanced signs of aging. He was overweight, scaling in at 127 kilograms. Richard started noticing a significant decline in his mental performance and physical health. His work as an attorney started to drop because he had trouble remembering notes from legal briefs. He was also in physical pain most of the day, which started as soon as he woke up. Bryan, being concerned for his father's health and life, convinced Richard to get on the Blueprint Protocol. After only 6 months of being on the protocol, focusing mostly on regular exercise, eating vegetables, and taking some supplements, Richard lost 23 kilograms, started feeling mentally sharp again, and regained physical energy. However, all was not good because Richard's speed of aging test came back concerning, showing that he was aging at an accelerated rate. Four epigenetic clock tests in the span of a month in March 2023 showed that Richard was aging faster than average, meaning that his risk for chronic disease and death were very high. That's when Bryan took things to the next level and had Richard undergo therapeutic plasma exchange, or TPE. For TPE therapy, the patient's blood is passed through an apheresis machine which separates the plasma from the red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets, a process called plasmapheresis. The cells are then mixed with donor plasma or saline with albumin and reintroduced into the patient. TPE is used to treat patients with autoimmune diseases, neurologic disorders, blood disorders, and even certain cancers. Equally exciting is the emerging evidence showing that exchanging old plasma with saline plus albumin, or diluting old blood plasma with young blood plasma, rejuvenates old tissues and organisms. Scientists have shown that a single round of TPE, in which half of the plasma in mice were replaced with saline plus 5% albumin, enhanced muscle repair, reduced fatty liver and fibrosis, and boosted hippocampal neurogenesis, a region in the brain critical to memory formation. Another group of researchers showed that blood plasma components from young mice called extracellular vesicles injected into old mice improved age-associated functional decline in multiple tissues, halted senescence, and extended the lifespan of these mice. Lastly, if you're thinking that this is great news for mice, but not necessarily for humans, there's a recent small clinical trial showing that rounds of TPE in humans improved many age-related changes, such as oxidative DNA damage, senescence, systemic markers of cancer pathways, and neurodegeneration markers. It's worth noting that it's still not known whether the rejuvenation benefits from these procedures is from removing old plasma or reintroducing new/young plasma, or both. But they do seem to work, just like they did for Richard, who received 1 liter of plasma from Bryan. On the other hand, Bryan received 1 liter of plasma from his 18-year-old son, or blood boy as he calls him, Talmadge. Richard's biological age decreased by a whopping equivalent of 25 years, meaning that he is aging at the rate of a 46-year-old from a single transfusion. To boot, his biological age stayed at that level for 6 months after, without undergoing any other interventions during that time span. Interestingly, Bryan's biological age didn't change after TPE. While this procedure is still highly experimental, there are four potential ways to replicate these results for you risk takers out there. The first option, which is the easiest to accomplish, but will likely yield lesser results, is regular blood donations. Blood donations only remove around 0.5 liter of blood, so you'll require frequent donations to keep diluting your plasma. Another potential issue with blood donations is that they also remove cells in your blood, which means your body will need to spend more energy to replenish them, potentially negating some of the rejuvenation properties of the therapy. But a major bonus of blood donations is that you can help save other lives. The second option is donating plasma. The amount of plasma removed per donation depends on the donor's weight. The average donation is around a quarter of a person's total plasma. Regular plasma donations may be needed to produce more robust effects. But on the flip side, you can help save lives and make money from donating plasma, with some people making up to $1,000 per month. The third option is performing TPE, where some or all of the old plasma is removed from the body and replaced with 1 to 2 liters of plasma from an ideally younger and healthier donor, similar to what Richard did. While it worked wonders for Richard, you may be wondering why Bryan did not see any measurable benefits when he received plasma from his younger son, Talmadge. His team speculates that this was likely because Bryan is already in prime condition, having the heart, skin, and fitness of individuals decades younger. It goes without saying that this third method is highly controversial and raises concerns about the elite and wealthy preying on the young and poor. For instance, at the Dallas clinic where the Johnsons had their procedure, the cost was around $5,500 per person. It's not a stretch to imagine this procedure creating a bigger divide between the lifespans and health spans of the old and wealthy versus the young and poor. The fourth option is performing TPE, where old plasma is typically completely removed from the body and replaced with saline solution containing albumin, meaning there is no donor or blood boy needed. A year after the first procedure, Bryan decided to give TPE another try, this time replacing his plasma with saline and albumin. His results are not yet known, but he did take a lot of baseline measurements before this therapy, including toxin levels, speed of aging, organ ages, microplastic levels, and many other biomarkers. There's a good chance Bryan won't see any benefits again, given his near optimal health. The clinician even noticed that after performing TPE for 9 years, Bryan's plasma is the cleanest he's ever seen, by far. This suggests that these therapies may be best suited for individuals that aren't in peak health. While we're still far away from thoroughly vetting the safety and utility of TPE in humans, the therapy is attracting a lot of attention. Comment below if you have or are thinking of being one of the first adopters, and if you would like a list of clinics in the USA offering TPE. For more information on revolutionary rejuvenation strategies, watch these videos and please support the channel by liking and subscribing.